figures to the last presentation on a topic that was widely discussed at the last session yesterday, and is the relationship between mutual and cooperative insurance and the Carrefour. And it's up now to Saleh to models. Thank you very much.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, salatu wassalamu ala Sayyidina Nabiyyina wa Mursaleen, Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. First of all, I thank the organizing committee or the organizing party of inviting me to share some of the thoughts that we in the cooperative side of the story are trying to share with you. For me, it was an excellent learning experience to be part of this excellent Carrefour gathering. Today, I was very impressed with the previous two presentations. Dr. Shahnaz presented this very interesting areas regarding the infrastructure and how we will be ready for this part, which probably I will touch on some comparisons. And Dr. Azman, probably the worst thing is to speak about or touch the Carrefour after a Malaysian expert and try to speak about it. But for me, I don't claim to be a Carrefour expert. I'm coming from the cooperative side. While this area in particular, I believe there's a mix up between even in statistics and what belongs to the Carrefour and what belongs to the cooperative side, sometimes in production as well. I'll be talking about some backgrounds and the Carrefour and cooperative milestones as well, and some different areas in the insurance market in Saudi. I will concentrate on the Saudi model and where it fits, or how do we see the Carrefour in Saudi Arabia. And is the cooperative another, or like a very, very, which one is coming from the other at the end of the day? And the first time we in Saudi started to talk about was like in 1976 in the first International Conference on Islamic Economics. That's the first time to our knowledge that this has started. The first official fatwa on the insurance, the cooperative insurance. After 1977, the Saudi Higher Council, Islamic Higher Council, did issue a fatwa that the cooperative insurance is the Sharia compliant version or form of insurance that's Islamically accepted. And the whole country did form its insurance development based on that fatwa for a long time. And we started with the government, the largest government company, which is Taunia, which was a government investment, and we developed the industry after that based on that fatwa. And it was the choice of the lawmakers, because we thought, socially, economically, and culturally, it is the best fit for the society and for the economy. We feel that the all the discussions about the fundamentals at the Carrefour concept are very similar to the cooperative and mutual principles, to the extent that the cooperative and mutual model in general is one that is accepted under Islamic law. We in the cooperative model feels that what we are doing is Islamically acceptable and is Sharia compliant, because the main thing now you find all companies are applying the core issue of the Sharia compliant to us is the funds, either the shareholders' funds or the policyholders' funds, which all the investments done in that is done in an Islamically or in a Sharia compliant investment. And if you look into the Saudi Saudi Arabia in general, the products naturally are Islamically acceptable. And what distinguished the cooperative from the conventional to us is the surplus sharing for the policyholders, and it was that main principle that started this issue. We had a mix-up for a while, for a number of years, where we had some companies applying the takaful model with the wakala fee system, the Tab Hassan case of deficit, and the whole model, and the remaining companies were in a takaful, which only the distribution of surplus is the only difference, and the issue of the investments of the insurance funds and the shareholders' funds. But we, in 2011, all companies being asked to really go back to the principle of cooperative insurance. No more takaful model. You cannot do any separate funds or become a manager of the fund, and all of the takaful stories is no longer valid in the Saudi system. And that means that, but it has to be, because the society, in the Saudi society, we are, you know, very concerned about that any project should be Sharia compliant. And people now going back with the Sharia courts and saying that if this is compliant, then the investment has to be compliant, the products has to be compliant. But sometimes the wording, we started playing with the wording, I mean, excuse my language, but the wording has been used similarly to the takaful wording, but the actual practice is a cooperative practice, straightforward, and we could say, like, you can do whatever after the bottom line in your income statement. After that, you can distribute whatever, but before that, you should stick to a conventional, you know, accounting system. But if we look at how we became successful in Saudi, I think it's the size of the market and that the cooperative did help the growth. And people don't see, you know, what can I get if we share the different concepts. We feel that if we look at the Saudi market, it's in 2011, it's getting close to $5 billion, and the growth in 2012 is, we will exceed, we'll get close to $7 billion. Health represents 52% of that, and we feel that also all the growth was in health and motor in the whole picture. Still, protection and saving is a problem in the cooperative, and probably, in my opinion, maybe a careful model, because people are not comfortable of the Sharia compliance of the life and protection of the system we have. Probably this could be a very good opportunity for such a model like a careful model to take over this portion of a huge market. We only getting to 1 billion riyal, which is, we're talking about close to $3 billion. Close to $300 billion, $300 million for a market of this size, of getting close to 30 million of inhabitants. And I think this is an area that we have to look at. The compulsory growth, for example, and I think one success, and I go back to Dr. Shena's presentation on the recommendation, the last recommendations on the page, was saying that we need to educate, regulate, we need to do the infrastructure, we have to do all of these for a takaful model. And I think the Saudi, we have an advantage that the market, for example, has done, the market itself, not the government, the market has done a huge job for the infrastructure, for the billing systems, if we look into the health alone, there was standards being set. What we call NCHIS, there was the National Center for Health Insurance Standards, which is represents 52-53% of the market. We have done the billing systems, the coding systems, we have done the approval forms and the claim forms, and we trained the providers across country, we trained the insurance companies across country. This is was done through a national center that is created by the market itself, by the industry. And this is where the challenge, if you wait for the government or the regulator to do this for you, it will not happen. You have to do it through the industry. And when we started the in 2006, implementing the compulsory health insurance, we reached 8.5 million insureds in 2012, and it's because of the infrastructure and because of the readiness and the training. And I think for us, this is a very important area, and I think the takaful would be an area that most likely would be the solution for the saving a life, because people are not yet, we could not penetrate the society of a classical product. Impact was large to Saudi economy, health delivery, and social lives. We believe it did attract specialized expat professional, in different fields. One area I would like to talk about, for example, if we take the health insurance as an example, the challenge was the change management. And we take change management seriously in this issue. How would even providers, medical providers, were the most problematic portion of it by resisting the change that a compulsory now, the compulsory health insurance will be implemented at once with different techniques, different billing requirements, different approval requirements. Now the regulator wants you to reply in 60 minutes. They want your billing to come at a certain time. You have to cover certain areas in the policy, on and on. And that change, I have conducted the research, qualitative research on the resistance to change in the Saudi private and government providers after the implementation of the cooperative health insurance. There was a large model. The study is available. The sample included the private hospitals, insurance companies, Ministry of Health, all the people dealing in health insurance, including National Guard hospitals. These are providers that provide service to insured members. Ministry of Health hospitals, especially the public hospitals in Saudi Arabia, we have government hospitals providing billing for services or fee for service for insureds going to government hospitals. And it's a lot larger study, but I'm just summarizing some of the areas of recommendations. For example, that we should have an appropriate orientation programs, and that was heavily implemented, training programs, adapting standards. Now, any system, for example, in the solutions or the IT systems, no IT systems for hospitals or for insurance companies can be sold in Saudi Arabia without adapting the NCHIS standards. That means it has to be catered to the market and to the requirements of the regulator, the billing, and the CCHI, and so on. And these have been established before, and this is where the challenge is. The health insurance, the accreditation programs and the quality improvements, fair payment incentives, and IT systems, because some people were not mechanized. Now you will have there is portals or hubs in the country that links payers to insured member to providers, and all of the dealing now starting very soon. All has to be in a coded manner for and it has to be done automatically. That means an online transmission of claims and also approvals as well. Privatizing and investing in health facilities, we are facing in the national level for our providers. We have a problem, major problem, with Ministry of Health hospitals. every time we change the Minister of Health, but that doesn't solve the problem. We have a serious problem in our national health system. We have over 300 major hospitals. We in the Ministry of Health alone, plus other hospitals, we have over 3,000 primary care centers in the country. But even with that huge investment, the country now, the budget for Ministry of Health alone is over 60 billion riyal. And that alone could not get us an easy access, an organized manner of healthcare system. The private is taken over now to serve the insurers, but it's not enough. Now it's compulsory for expatriates, which we said it's about 8.5 million people. And now Saudis now will enter that market as well with over 20 million people as well. And that will require a very strong delivery system, bios, infrastructure, which luckily we have huge infrastructure for the billing and the delivery side. How we understand the TKAFL is theoretically TKAFL is perceived as cooperative insurers where members contribute a certain sum of money or as we said, and the purpose of that, the system is not profitable. We don't see it as a profit-making system, and it is like the group is bearing the burden for anyone who is in need. To us, we see it as a charity, as made to help the needy, that it contributes to time of need. These positive principles of TKAFL in general, even the community, it's a community oriented, no time limit to pay back. It encourages social economy in general. But one major concern of the cooperative, let's say, audience about TKAFL, that the competition itself, but our main issue is the reinsurance side and the commitment of capital. That's how we see that the TKAFL is different. And probably the lawmakers or the regulators, I think this is major concern in the Saudi side of it. Because we have a problem that if you are given a qarb hasan in case of deficit of the pool, then at the end of the day, the shareholders' capital commitment to the insurance operation to us is not a complete cycle. We feel that the careful issue is like the shareholders can say at one day, enough is enough, we will not support the fund, and then you will start having an operation that might have an issue. This is one, and another issue is the reinsurance long-term arrangements. We look also at the pool of carriers, same way as we look at the pool of reinsurance. Who contributes into the pool, like if you are a reinsurance company, your customers or your sharing in the pool are the ceding companies, and then if it has deficits, you will support that pool as a reinsurer with a qarb hasan, and you will get it back at the good times. But that equation, what is the responsibility of the ceding companies within that relationship is a concern to us. What did reinsurers do? Reinsurers said there is a clause, and I talked to them about that one day, that will waive any responsibility for insurance companies of any future liabilities towards the fund. Okay, if it's Islamically, Islamic principle issue, then I should share the good times and the bad times, and I share the loss and the profit. But it seems like sometimes we turn into, even the read the careful with all respect, it turns into a conventional at the end of the day. And I think this is a question that needs to be answered. And to us, if it boils down to the same thing, then why are we, for us, why encourages us to look into takaful as an alternative. And I agree with you, for social reason, we believe probably in the Saudi market and the GCC, maybe a takaful savings could be a solution because people will feel comfortable. It's a selling tool. But we feel that the reinsurance issue is a major concern to us. And, you know, even a free market, mechanism probably would not be very strong within the takaful, in our opinion, and the entrepreneurship, because your capital is not committed, you don't see it as a straightforward relationship, that's maybe a concern. What did we do in the Saudi market to line up between the two? Because our religious and our scholars, Sharia, let's call them, religious is probably not the right word, but our Sharia scholars are pushing towards that. And let me just tell you a little bit about the scholars. I worked with them so much. We have to guide them sometimes to, you know, and because they don't know Shuras, they will listen to some strong voice in the committee guides them that this is haram, everybody else will just back off. And this is really a major concern. And I would encourage the institutions, like especially the Islamic educational universities, to start something about like the Sharia board members education. I don't know, but because it's a good business, by the way. You can graduate a lot of people who could be members from the Sharia boards. They would be excellent jobs because I know people who are on 20, 30, 40 boards. And probably we should have a way to educate these members because they are making the destiny for the whole industry. And if they don't know, they will just keep us moving not in the right direction sometimes. We worked with the scholars and we explained to them that from a regulator point of view, there is no takaful market in Saudi Arabia. That is separate from wakala, abhasan, the whole equation. Then what can we do? The condition, because there is now a list of what they call halal companies, and there is companies that are not as pure and so on in the Saudi market. And there is conditions. One condition is your investments. They have to be invested in a Sharia compliant tools and also worked with us in identifying the common grounds, as we mentioned, the insurance products to be compliant with the Sharia principles. Luckily in Saudi Arabia we don't have the major problems like alcohol, like pork, like this, and especially they call it the riba banks. That's the only thing that probably will be prevented of ensuring, you know, no products or financial protections for such banks. But now we have enough, Sharia compliant banks. Even the banks, everybody is now having Sharia compliant, investment tools. The surplus, and this is a major change in the cooperative model, by the way. The surplus distribution to policyholders used to be maximum 10%. And now the regulator has changed that to be minimum. That means the company, the shareholders, can give more than 10% to policyholders if they want to encourage. Different from the dividends, this is just for policyholders' surplus distribution, which is the major change in the Saudi in the cooperative side. And now it's a minimum, you can give 20 and 30 and 40, and the remaining, and now with the new wording, you can give that as a tabarru to the company. This is the wording we changed this area. And that's where we changed the policy wording to reflect more Sharia compliance wording, similar to takaful, but less concentrated in the approach itself. The Sharia compliance is a fundamental principle in the Saudi culture, and that's why everyone is concerned. And all of the uncertainties that we talked about in the takaful model, regarding the all other areas, we find that the growth that we are experiencing in the cooperative is encouraging, and that's why we don't see that we need to move. But I think the only thing that we learned about the investment and savings on the Takaful model probably would be one alternative. And we feel that depending on what each company or country or community ambitions are based on, based on the economic environment as well as the country's economical strength, should make the right choice between cooperative and Takaful design. Thank you very much.